Hi guys, this is Anash Sharma and I welcome to you in my channel Lotus Summage. And today's lesson we will learn what is a subquery, what are the types of the subquery, and we will do all type of subquery with examples and diagram on the SQL Server. Now, what is a subquery? The query within the query, it is called the subquery. Sometimes it is also called inner query or inner select. As you can see in the diagram, we have four queries. The first one is the main query. Within the body of the main query, we have the another query that is called the subquery 1. And then within the body of the subquery 1, we have the subquery 2. And then within the body of the subquery 2, we have the subquery 3. It means you write a main query and then you write another query within the body of the main query, that query becomes the subquery. There are some rules for the subquery. The rule number one, the innermost query, in this diagram you can see the subquery 3, this one. This query will execute first. Then the result of this query will pass to its parent query. It means subquery 2. Then this query is executed and the result of this query is supplied to its parent query, that is the subquery. Now this query is executed and finally the result is supplied to the main query. Then main query actually fetch the data, display the result set. There are some rules for this subquery. The subquery must be enclosed within the parenthesis. In the subquery, you can use the some comparison operator like greater than, less than, or less than equal, greater than equal. Order by command cannot be used in the subquery. Let us discuss about the types of the subqueries. There are three types of the subquery. The first one is the single row subquery. In this subquery, the subquery returns single row output. And second one is the multiple row subquery. In this multiple row subquery, this query returns the multiple row, more than one row. And third one is the correlated subquery. In the correlated subquery, the inner query depends on the outer query of its value. It means the inner query executes repeatedly for all the row of the or all the values of the outer query. Okay. Let us do the practical on the SQL Server. For the single row return subquery, for that purpose we have two table. Let me check it. So in this student table we have the roll number and the name of the students and the city in which the student lives. The second table we have, in the second table, student marks. We have the roll number and the marks in three subjects obtained by the student. In both tables, the roll number is common. Our query is, we have to find out the details of the marks obtained by the Anil who lives in Delhi. So in that case, we have to make sure that subquery returns single value. If we see the student table, Anil is the only student and he lives Delhi, whose roll number is 1. It means the information are in different tables, in student table and the student marks table. So first of all, we will take out the roll number from the student table because we have the information, the name of the students and the city of the student. Then we will take out the roll number from the student table and will supply to that roll number to the our main query. Our main query will fetch the data from the student marks table. Let us write a subquery. So I have written a query. This is the main query, and another query is within the parenthesis. So this is called the subquery. So from the subquery, we are getting the roll number, the single roll number. On the basis of the information, we have the name of the student, that is the Anil, and the city. So this subquery will return the single row output that is supplied to the main query. So the subquery will return the single row output, that is the roll number. And the roll number is common in both table. So in the main query, we have the where clause. So the roll number is supplied from the subquery. In the main query, on the basis of the roll number, we get the details from the stored marks table. Okay, I execute this query. So you can see we have the details of the students whose roll number is 1. Suppose if execute only this query, so you can see it is returning only single row value. Now suppose I change this query subquery and I write where city equal to Noida. So if I execute this subquery, then we have the multiple row output. So if I execute this whole query, then we get the error because we are using the in the main query, that is the equal operator. In case of the equal operator, we have to make sure the subquery returns single row output. Even you can see in the error descriptions that if you are using these operator, then you have to make sure your subquery returns single row output. We can also check the diagram. In this diagram, you can see we have a main query. In this main query, we are getting the details from the student marks table. And in where clause, we have the roll number. Roll number, we are passing from the subquery. On the subquery, we are getting the roll number on the basis of the name and the city. That is the Anil and the Delhi. In student table, you can check the Anil and the Delhi. This combination makes the unique, and that roll number is 1. Roll number is being supplied from the subquery to the main query. Now we have to check the subquery with the multiple row return. Our query is how to find the marks of students who lives in Noida. So this is our query. If I execute this query, then I get the error because this subquery is written in the multiple row. So in that case, we cannot use the equal operator. If the subquery is returning multiple row, then we have to use the in operator. Then I replace this one and now execute this query. So there are two students who lives in Noida. We can check the functionality of the subquery with the multiple row return with this diagram. You can see in this diagram, in the main query, we are getting the details from the student marks tables. And in where clause, we have the in operator because the subquery will return the multiple row returns. In the subquery, we have the roll number from student where city equal to Noida. And student table, you can see there are two records with Noida value. So, and roll number is 67. Then 67 roll number is supplied to the main query. Then in main query, it gets the details from the student marks tables on the basis of the roll number 6 and 7. If I use the not in this query, say, then execute this query, it means the roll number 67 is not included in this result. You can also use the any operator with the combination of the other operator. If the subquery is written in the multiple row, then you can use the equal to any operator. As you can see the diagram, I am using this equal to any operator. This is very similar to in operator. So this subquery returns the 6-7 roll number, and the 6-7 is compared with the from 1 to 10, and the result is the 6-7 roll number. If I change this query, I change the operator, say any, and I execute this one, then I get the error, because any operator should be used with the combination of the other operators, say equal to. So this is very similar to any operator, then roll number is 6-7. If I use say greater than, then roll number greater than 6 or 7. If I say use less than, then less than 6-7. Now we come to the insert subquery. First of all, we check a table. We have a table that is a student backup table, and right now there is no data in this table. So we will copy all the data from the student marks table to into this table using the insert subquery. So you can see I have written a query that is the insert into backup table, and these are the columns of the list, and we are taking the data from the student marks table, that's select user. So this is the subquery for this instance. If I execute this one and again check this table, backup table, then you can see all the data are copied in the backup table using the insert subquery. So you can see in the total, all values are the null. So we can insert a calculated column in this total column. How? Suppose say total, then now, if I execute this query, and again check this one, so next 10 records you can see the total is there. So what I have done, I have taken one more table column, that is the total, and in this insert query, I have added the marks of 3 subjects as a calculated column. Now we will check how to use the correlated subquery for finding out the highest salary. What is correlated subquery? In correlated subquery, the subquery executes for every row of the outer query. What does it mean? In the diagram you can see, we have a 10 row in outer query, means 10 salaries. When you use the subquery, correlated subquery, so what happens? The very first value is passed, say 3000, to the correlated subquery. That 3000 is compared or is processed with every row of the outer query, that is the 10 rows. The processing is over, then second value is passed, say 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, the processing is same. The 2, 3, 4, 5 is compared with the 10 rows, 10 values of the salary. So it means the count of processing would be the 100, 10 multiplied by 10. So this is how the correlated subquery works. We can also check the another diagram for working of the correlated subquery As you can see in the right side, we have a table, and in that table we have the number from 1 to 10, and 10 is duplicate. So suppose we pass a value that is a 10, and we want to find out less than equal to 10. So result is there are two 10s, less than equal to, but the distinct count of these two is the 1. It means the 10 is on the first position. 10 is the highest salary. If we pass the second value, that is the 8, it means less than equal to, there are three numbers, but 10 is again is a duplicate, so distinct count is the 2. It means the 8 is the second highest number. Then we have the 7, 6, and we have the their position number, say 3rd or 4th. So basically these numbers, distinct count indicates these are the highest salary on this number. Now we know how the correlative subquery works. So now we have a query, select salary from employee, and PQ is the alias, and where 2. 2 equal to the result from the subquery. The subquery is returning the count of the result. So as you, in the diagram you can see 3000, first value is passed, and 3000 is compared less than equal to with all these values. So green mark is indicates these values, 3000 is less than equal to. So count is the 4, distinct count. It means the condition is false because we want count 2, distinct count 2. So condition is false. Again the step 2, second value is passed, 2, 3, 4, 5, and distinct count is 5. Condition is false, but on the 5th position, this is the highest salary, 2, 3, 4, 5. In next step, whenever the 5000 passed, now the count is 3, distinct count, because there are 4 values, 7666, again 7666, then 5000, 6000. So 5000 is less than equal to of all these values. So still the condition is false, but if we want to calculate the 3rd highest salary, then condition is true. Finally, when the 6000 is passed, the distinct count is the 2. The condition is true. Now the 6000 is the current value from the outer query. So the result would be the 6000. So it means 6000 is the highest salary. Now we can check this query on the SQL server. So this is the second highest salary. If I make it 3, it means 5000 is the third highest salary. If I make 4, so it's a duplicate. So 3000 is the fourth highest salary. So this way we can find out the highest salary using the correlated subquery. So guys, this was all about the SQL subqueries. If you like this video, please share and subscribe. Thanks for watching the video.